Well, hello, folks. Dr. Charles Parker here. One more key point from new ADHD medication rules. And this one has to do with a word that isn't really on everybody's tongue. It's not something you run around talking about at dinner parties, but the key word is metabolism. It's how the body burns medication. Almost all of what we talk about and all the details of the book have some reference to that point about metabolism, because if we don't really pay attention to how that specific body is burning the medication, we are absolutely determined we're not going to get that medication correctly adjusted for that individual, and they will feel like a treatment failure. What is metabolism? It's really very simple. It's a whole host of different things that affect the dosage and the timing of the medication and how you give the medication through the day. It's really the burn rate, for want of a better term. It's the burn rate. The very first sentence in new ADHD medication rules is, we have to remember this key point. The meds have to pass through the body to get to the mind. So often overlooked. I mean, is that common sense or what? But if we don't think about what's going through the body, they're not going to get to the mind. And I'm going to have a number of different videos coming up. They're going to talk about issues like immunity and specific. We already talked about genetics, 2D6. If you look over on the 2D6, that's a liver pathway that can change dramatically how the medications are burned. One of the key things we do is we look at 2D6 as we actually think about giving a person medication, because we want to know whether they're going to be able to metabolize it correctly. So we have to have this one key point in mind. Metabolism matters, how the body manages the medication matters, and there are no, read my lips on this, folks, there are no cookie cutter solutions to medications for attention deficit disorder medications. Each medication has to be customized for each individual, and no medication works best for everybody. Now, having said that, I'm going to give you one little flyer. In my clinical experience, and I have this documented from Mary Salanto, Stimulant Medications and ADHD. The bottom line is the Mary Salanto book, and it'll be referenced down here so you can take a look at that. Mary Salanto made a very good assessment of the matters. Amphetamines versus methylphenidate products, how do they actually stack up? And one of the points she made is that amphetamines, for a number of different psychopharmacologic reasons, they actually do a better job than methylphenidate products. And I'm not going to go into them here. I'm going to wear you out with the details. But the bottom line is, in our clinical experience, amphetamines work better than methylphenidate products. Now, methylphenidate products are more forgiving because they're different in the way they metabolize. Amphetamine products, it's really kind of, if you will, a sharper knife that you have to pay greater attention to. If you're not thinking and you don't want to think, methylphenidate products are going to be more forgiving because you've got a lot of room for doing whatever you want to do without really thinking. If you're going to get the medication right, then you're going to use the sharp knife. You're going to get in there and use an amphetamine product. It's going to actually be more successful. Yeah, there's some different papers that say some are better than others for hyperkinetic and non-hyperkinetic. It's been my experience in my practice that, as a rule, amphetamines are better than methylphenidate products. Not for everybody. I'm not making a rule there, really. I did say rule, but we're really talking about the overview. Generally speaking, amphetamines do work better. Thanks. Appreciate your attention. You have a good one. Talk later.